The bombs dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki caused explosions equivalent to 15 kilotons of TNT. The amount of radioactive gases released into the atmosphere by this blast was 400 times less than those released in an incident where a large dome can now be seen. This dome, 354 feet high and 840 feet wide, covers the history of an incident that even shook America's greatest enemy at the time, the Soviet Union. This explosion is known as the Chernobyl nuclear disaster, where a small mistake astonishingly caused a blast equivalent to 225 tons of TNT. The Chernobyl nuclear plant was built in the city of Pripyat, 100 kilometers away from Ukraine's capital, Kyiv. This area is now completely desolate. At that time, Ukraine was part of the Soviet Union. As you all know, this was the era of the Cold War, and the Soviet Union started constructing many power plants using nuclear energy, including Chernobyl. This power plant consisted of 4 nuclear reactors, named 1, 2, 3, and 4. The fourth one, which was built last, is now covered by a large dome. These 4 reactors had the capacity to produce 1,000 megawatts of electricity each, meeting the electricity demands of half the population of the Soviet Union at that time. In simple terms, if we understand the working of these reactors, they used nuclear reactions to heat water. This water turned into steam, which drove turbines, and the rotation of these turbines generated electricity. However, since a nuclear reaction is a chain reaction, meaning once it starts, it cannot be controlled easily. Therefore, to control the nuclear reaction, 211 control rods were placed in each reactor. These control rods were made of a material that absorbs the neutrons released during the nuclear reaction. Because it's these neutrons that combine with uranium atoms to create the nuclear reaction, if the neutrons stick to the control rods instead of uranium, the nuclear reaction will naturally slow down. In the case of Chernobyl, these control rods were made of boron carbide with tips made of graphite. Remember that this process ran 24/7, resulting in temperatures inside the reactor reaching 1600 degrees Celsius. This temperature is nearly 30% of the surface temperature of the sun, and hence, keeping the reactor cool was crucial. For this purpose, water lines inside the reactor were operated. This water, circulated with the help of pumps, was constantly moving inside the reactor. This is similar to how coolant is used to keep a car's engine cool. There was a significant design flaw in the Chernobyl reactor, which perhaps was underestimated by many. In the case of a car, the circulation of water stops as soon as the engine is turned off. However, in a nuclear reactor, the water circulation should not stop for even a second, even if the nuclear reaction ceases. This is because the reactor continues to produce heat for a considerable time after the reaction has stopped. Therefore, it was essential that these water pumps operated continuously without any interruption. Obviously, these water pumps also required electricity to operate. Normally, this electricity was provided by the reactor's own turbines. In the event of power failure, special backup diesel generators were installed. But the problem was that it would take up to 60 seconds to switch to diesel generators, during which the water pumps would be off. Engineers wanted the pumps to not stop during these 60 seconds. Hence, a system was installed for this purpose. The system was designed so that as soon as the reactor was shut down, it wouldn't immediately stop producing electricity. The production of 1,000 megawatts would gradually decrease. During this time, the remaining electricity would be used to keep the pumps running for 60 seconds until the backup generators kicked in. This system had been installed, but its testing was still pending, which was a mandatory process. This testing was only pending for Reactor 4, as Reactors 1, 2, and 3 had already successfully undergone these tests. It was the evening of April 25th, 1986, and preparations were underway to perform the safety test on Reactor 4. This test was being conducted under the supervision of Deputy Chief Engineer Anatoly Dyatlov. Previously, this test had not been successful on Reactor 4, hence it was said that the Deputy Chief Engineer was determined to perform the test successfully that night. According to the rulebook, this test should be performed when the reactor is producing 700 megawatts of power. Normally, it produced 1,000 megawatts, so Deputy Chief Engineer ordered the insertion of control rods to slow down the reactor, which began to slow the nuclear reaction. Everything was proceeding normally until then. But perhaps too many control rods were inserted. causing the reactor's power to plummet from 1,000 megawatts to just 30 megawatts. To increase the power again, some control rods were partially withdrawn, bringing the power up to 200 megawatts. To further increase power, more control rods were withdrawn. Now, only 8 of the 211 control rods remained inside the reactor, which was a violation of the rulebook. The rulebook stated that there should not be fewer than 15 control rods in the reactor. Due to this violation, the reaction accelerated rapidly, and the power increased from 200 megawatts, surpassing 1,000 megawatts, and reaching several thousand megawatts. Due to this excessive heat, the water in the pipes started evaporating rapidly, which was actually supposed to cool the reactor core. A wave of fear swept through the control room, and the entire reactor began to vibrate. There was only one solution to control this. Press the emergency shutdown button, which would insert all control rods into the reactor and stop the nuclear reaction. And that's what the engineers did. They immediately pressed the emergency shutdown button. But as soon as the control rods were inserted, the reactor exploded with a massive blast. The intensity of the explosion was recorded on a seismogram as equivalent to a 225-ton TNT blast. For comparison, the nuclear bomb dropped on Hiroshima, named Little Boy, released dangerous gases into the atmosphere. This Chernobyl disaster released 400 times more gases than the Hiroshima bombing. At the time, it was 1:26 a.m. on April 26, 1986. The question arises, if control rods are meant to slow down the reaction, why did they accelerate it instead? The explosion actually occurred due to the graphite tips on the control rods. As mentioned earlier, these control rods were made of boron carbide, but their tips were made of graphite. While boron carbide can stop a nuclear reaction, graphite actually accelerates it. The reaction, already exceeding its limit, accelerated rapidly as soon as the graphite-tipped rods were inserted, exceeding the tolerance of the reactor's walls, leading to their rupture and explosion. Two engineers were killed on the spot, and two others were severely burned. The explosion caused a fire in reactor 4 of the plant. Initially, it was treated as a regular fire, as no one knew that 5% of the radioactive material had already been released into the atmosphere. Firefighters arrived at the scene and attempted to extinguish the fire with water. But this was no ordinary fire. It was a graphite fire, which is not easily extinguished. Shortly after the disaster, the entire city of Pripyat, with a population of about 50,000, was evacuated overnight. The Soviet Union declared an emergency and arranged hundreds of buses to transport the residents to the city of Slavutich, far away from Pripyat. In Chernobyl, the effort to extinguish the fire continued for the next 10 days. Over 5,000 tons of sand, clay, and other materials were dropped from helicopters to gain control over the fire. Finally, after 10 days, the fire was extinguished, but radioactive gases continued to be released into the atmosphere for several more days. The firefighters who were battling the fire fell ill due to exposure to radioactive gases, and some died in the following days and months. Initially, the Soviet Union wanted to suppress news of the incident, as it was the era of the Cold War, and such news could severely tarnish the Soviet Union's image. However, the secret couldn't be kept hidden for long. 36 hours after the explosion, on April 28th, a Swedish radiation monitoring station noticed that radiation levels in the air were continuously increasing, and the radiations were coming from Ukraine. Consequently, the Soviet government was eventually forced to disclose the incident to the world. Even after the fire in Chernobyl's reactor 4 was extinguished, the danger was not completely averted. There was a pool of water under the reactor, which had accumulated a large amount of radioactive material. If not emptied in time, the steam from this water could release more radioactive gases into the air. The only way to empty it was for someone to dive into the pool and open the drain valve at the bottom. But entering this radioactive water was essentially a suicide mission, and no one was willing to undertake it. Then, three heroes, or rather superheroes, stepped forward. Mechanical engineer Alexei Ananenko, senior engineer Valery Bespalov, and shift supervisor Boris Baranov. They decided to risk their lives to save others. These three divers entered the pool and, swimming in the dark, opened its drains, thus emptying the water and stopping the reaction. Their mission was considered by many as a suicide mission. But fortunately, all three emerged safely. But by then, significant damage had already been done. As a result of the explosion, iodine-131 and other dangerous chemicals were released into the air, causing thousands of people to develop thyroid cancer, and many thousands died because of it. Most of these were people associated with the firefighting team and those who later participated in the Chernobyl cleanup operation. Moreover, these chemicals wreaked havoc across Europe. Forests where this radioactive waste fell turned from green to red. With the rain, these chemicals spread to the grass in various areas, and the animals that grazed on this contaminated grass also suffered significant harm. In the first 4 months following the disaster, only 31 people were reported dead, but the radiation released into the air caused the deaths of approximately 4,000 people in the following years. This figure is merely an estimate. The actual number of deaths caused by the disaster is difficult to determine. Today, 38 years after the Chernobyl disaster, the public is not allowed to visit the site because it is still emitting radiation, which will continue to be harmful for the next 400 years. To prevent the spread of these radiations into the air, the government installed a large dome over the site. The construction of this dome cost approximately $3 billion, and it is expected to prevent the spread of radiation from the Chernobyl disaster into the atmosphere for the next 100 years.